Welcome to the Ultra Serving Program at Related to Fields. You have been chosen to be part of our Ultra Serving team. First, I will go through what an Ultra Server is. Secondly, your duties as an Ultra Server here in the parish. An Ultra Server is a lay assistant to the priest during the Mass or to other members of the clergy in other religious functions, including benediction and Eucharistic adoration. An Ultra Server is not to be confused with an acolyte. Before the Second Vatican Council, the acolyte was the highest of the minor orders, having duties including the lighting of the altar candles, carrying the candles in procession, assisting the subdeacon and the deacon, and ministering the water and wine to the priest. Acolytes wore either the alb or the surplice over a cassock. The order of acolyte was conferred on a seminarian at a minor ordination. After the reforms of the minor orders in 1972, the acolyte survived but became one of the two lay ministers. Therefore, the acolyte is not to be confused with the altar server, even though the altar server can do the already mentioned duties of the acolyte. The Mass is the summit of worship for us as Catholics. We relive the sacrifice of Jesus and receive His most precious body and blood in the Eucharist. Your job as altar servers is to assist the priest or deacon during the Mass. I want you to keep in mind one main principle before you learn exactly how to do that. You are on the sanctuary to add to the reverence of the Mass. That implies that you should not be distracting and help the congregation focus on the main part of the Mass. Jesus. That's all the time we have for today, but now it's time to start serving. Come on.
So you're going to walk into the sacristy and find an alb that's your size. Once you've found that alb, take it off the hanger and put it on like you would put on a shirt. A bit more gracefully than he's going to do it. And then find the buttons and button from the top up. So you're going to take the cincture, fold it over itself, and then wrap it around your body. Take the end of the cincture and fold it over itself again so that you have a loop. Take the end of the cincture, put it through the loop, and then pull it tight so that it fits nicely around your waist. Remember, a well-dressed altar server is a happy altar server. Enter the sacristy at the end of the breezeway right before the double doors. The sacristy is located on the
right.
Go
on, get your cross. Go on.
The altar serving crosses are located on a corkboard to your right at the end of the hallway. As previously stated, the Mass is the summit of worship for Catholics. We begin the Mass with a procession, in which we carry the cross and lead the priest to the altar. Once we arrive at the altar, we genuflect with the priest and ascend unto the altar. Crossbearer puts the cross on the stand in the back. When the priest says, "Let us pray," the crossbearer carries the sacramentary to him. The priest opens the sacramentary and hands it back to the altar server. Be sure to hold the book still. After the prayer, sit down with the congregation. When sitting, be sure to keep your back straight, hands on your knees, and head forward. We begin the liturgy of the Eucharist as a parishioner brings up the gifts. The priest hands the gifts off to the servers, who will carry them back to the credence table. The servers will then carry the gifts one by one to the altar. After the priest pours the wine and water into the chalices, the altar servers wash his hands by pouring water over them. The crossbearer holds a cloth for the priest to dry his hands. The altar servers kneel at the altar, and one prepares to ring the bells. The bell should be rung loudly and strongly, three distinct times, once for each member of the Trinity. After communion, it's time to do the dishes. After cleaning each item, the priest hands them to the servers, who returns them to the credence table. The recession is when the altar servers and priests leave the sanctuary, ending the Mass. After the final blessing, we will escort the priest down to the bottom of the sanctuary, genuflect with the priest, and escort him out.